Welcome, because we are here with another Star Series match. We have Dara versus zNation. zNation on the dire side, Dara on the radiant side. And it's just one game, or at least best out of one, way Star Series works. And we're gonna go into the draft phase right now. I won't have a co-caster with me today or tonight, or at least with this game, there won't be any. So you'll have to do with me, but I hope it will be fine. I hope so, but we will see. We will see, as Artstyle can have the honor of having the first pick. Well, zNation has the honor of being Dire, so a bit close to Roshan. If you can call that a privilege. Oh, I just checked if my microphone was actually on, which it is, so you can actually hear me. It's good news. We already have some bans going on. We have the Broodmother ban, we have a Lycan ban. Jhen is being banned right now.
Dire team banned.
And, well, Invoker, this is not very exciting
Radiant
banned,
team
really.
banned.
This is pretty standard. And standard bans, well, actually, for Dara at least, standard bans are not very standard, I guess. Not that standard anyway, as they like to surprise opposite teams. Let's see what their last ban is going to be. It's going to be Dark, so you're still standard indeed. They're
Dire
going to probably
team
hope to either
banned.
pick up a Furion or. What's still in there? Still Lashrakin, they're still tied onto Windrunner, even though they don't get picked up that much anymore lately. A Brewmaster is still in, of course, almost forgot that one. And Enchantress, they like Enchantress, I believe, so. Let's see.
Ten seconds
Let's see which one
remaining.
zNation is gonna let through for Dare to pick up as their first pick.
5 seconds
If it's
remaining.
gonna be one of those, or if it's gonna be if they're gonna be something else, because they can choose
Declared time.
to ban out something totally different than all the heroes I just mentioned, just to be able to still have two of the heroes I just mentioned for themselves to pick up as soon as they're allowed to pick, and just giving one away to Dare, but picking up two of the most wanted heroes themselves. So if they don't get the Brewmaster, they'll get the Furion. If they don't get a Furion, they get the Brewmaster, and they're gonna ban out the Furion
Radiant
regardless.
team
So we
picked.
might see a Brewmaster picked up right now,
Lashrak.
but it's gonna be Lashrak. One of those heroes that
Dire
is
team
good in
picked.
every phase of the game. And you can't really tell from the first pick what kind of strategy Dara is aiming for either, because Lashrak basically fits in everything. He can go support, he can go ganking, he can go he can go middle, he can go farming on lane, pushing towers really fast. It's one of those heroes that you just can't expect what he's gonna be played as until the game actually
10 seconds
starts and you see him on the lane.
remaining.
That is. Let's see what the answer
Five
for that
seconds
is on
remaining.
for zNation. The Brewmaster's still in. I said him. I mean,
Reserve time.
he's not picked up that often anymore. I mean, he's a great utility
Reserve
hero,
time.
but you really have to have someone
Enchantress.
in your team that's able to play him and able to play him
Radiant
to the full
team.
potential. And you have to expect that you're going to be able to get him farmed up
Radiant team picked.
in time to be useful in the entire fight, of course. Oh, I like this lineup from there
Dire
right now. We
team
have
picked.
an Enigma, so that's already a good jungler right there. It's as a reply for the Enchantress. Enchantress is going to be in the jungle for zNation. And as a reply to that, Enigma is going to probably, that's my expectation
Go
anyway,
through
is going to be in the jungle for Dare. And Enigma
Radiant
farms
team
way
banned.
faster than Enchantress in the forest. So they have the advantage, or gold advantage at least, for those two. Even though Enchantress is, of course, more present early game, and she can help gank already from out of the forest. And Shadow Demon being picked up by Dare
Dire
purely
team
so that he
banned.
can put down his disruption. Well, put down his
Radiant
disruption.
team
He can
banned.
disrupt the hero, and then Lashrak can come in and stun straightly after. So that's a guaranteed stun from Lashrak. Means that he only has to spec it once or twice in order for it to be useful. So he can use his other skills for. The Lightning Storm and the Diabolic Edict. And for, zNation, we have the Enchantress picked up. Strong hero. Aggressive early game. Probably gonna see that. And they have a Beastmaster and a Lone Druid. Now, Lone Druid is usually, well, is a potential in the forest. But since they already have Enchantress, I'm expecting Lone Druid to be on a solo lane. With Beastmaster
Ten
maybe in the
seconds
middle lane, they
remaining.
have a lot of options laning here, so don't pin me down on this one. I mean, they could go
Five
with a lot of
seconds
ways for this
remaining.
one. But Beastmaster could be a solo and will have great rune control for that one with his Hawk and his
Reserve
Boar if he
time.
goes for that, which he normally does if he's in the middle. And, they can just go
Dire
for
team
still one
banned.
very strong off lane that is a potential try lane with Enchantress coming out of the forest. So they have a lot of options open still, but the options that they won't have is a. Death Prophet, because that one got banned out by Dare. They don't want to be pushed like that. They don't want to deal with the silence because their heroes rely on spells so far, and it's just a very, very annoying hero to deal with. You can't really force a team fight either when the exorcism is going through, so banning out that one. Brewmaster being banned out.
Radiant
Well,
team
just like
picked.
I said, he is annoying hero to deal with. He has a lot of, well, when he splits up, he has a lot of utilities, and they don't want to deal with that. Bane being banned out. Because Dare likes to play Bane, so that's the ban out, I think, because of that, so more like a respect ban. And a Windrunner ban out because, yeah, well, zNation doesn't want to
Queen
have her
of
because they
Pain.
already have their
Dire
solo
team
lanes,
picked.
and well, they don't want Dare with that solo lane hero, but they're gonna pick up a Queen of Pain instead, which is probably gonna be either a solo side lane or a mid lane. But yeah, so far I have to note, there is, apart from Enigma, I mean, Sand King is not picked up. Tidehunter is not picked up. What's with that? Earthshaker is still there
Sandpicker
too,
is
but he's not
remaining.
picked up that often. I feel like zNation is missing some team
Five
fight right now. Of
seconds
course, they have the
remaining.
shout from the Beastmaster, which is very useful. And of course, will be very annoying
Dire
for
team.
Enigma if he's gonna have his, well, even if he has a BKB, it doesn't matter, it will go through and it will stop the black hole from being casted. So Enigma has to make sure that Beastmaster is either not around or is in that black hole that he's gonna cast. But there's no, that's basically the only team fight that they have. So I'm thinking
Crystal
about
Maiden.
what strategy they're going for here.
Radiant
And
team
they're probably,
picked.
our zNation is their last pickup, is probably going to get a hard carry. So they will probably maintain lane control, try to maintain lane control, maybe push some with Enchantress and the Lone Druid. And with the last hero that's going to be picked up. And get their carry farmed up enough so that he can take out the whole team of Dare. But Dare is looking pretty good right now also. I mean, they have Queen of Pain, can go ganking fairly early.
10 seconds
If her
remaining.
team is winning the lanes, however, she's probably gonna just stay and continue her
Five
farm. She's
seconds
very useful for
remaining.
that too. And well, they can push. They have Lurshak and Enigma, very
Reserve
great pushing
time.
heroes. They can stop ganks from incoming if a Shadow Demon is on the lane where the Enchantress and the well, possible trial semi tri lane is gonna be happening. That's what I'm expecting. I'm not saying it's gonna be. That's what I expect. But I would like to see them do that. But yeah, then the disruption can go through and the gank would be totally failed. And let's see what the last pickup for Dare is gonna be. Actually, they have a dual lane with Lurshak and Shadow Demon if they want to. They can send Enigma into the forest. They have Queen of Pain that they can send also somewhere solo lane, and they have one solo lane left that they can go for. Well, they could also have a tri lane still with Lurshak and Shadow Demon. They have a lot of options. They could go for something like a Sand King still, they could go for a Storm Spirit. But then again, it's there. They could do something totally unexpected, which none of us can predict. Well, probably some can, but I can't. And they're running out of time, or at least they have 30 seconds left for the last pick. Let's see what they're gonna pick up. Can't really say anything other than that. They're gonna have their support as a Shadow Demon, so we already know that Lurshak is gonna be either a semi-support or gonna actually be the one that farms on the lane together with the Shadow Demon.
10 seconds remaining.
If Lurshak and if Enigma,
Night
oh,
Stalker.
they're gonna go with a Night Stalker,
Dire
so
team
that's gonna be
picked.
probably either a solo lane or it's gonna be supported by the Shadow Demon with Lurshak solo mid, but I'm expecting it's gonna be a solo lane. And we're gonna see some early ganks outcoming from them, even though I think Night Stalker will have a pretty tough time. Of course, Enchantress will be in the forest, so if Enchantress is not careful, she will be caught out in the nighttime if she's not near a tower, which she probably will, but she will be very careful for that because
Ten
she is
seconds remaining.
just so squishy. With the silence there on Night Stalker too.
5 seconds remaining.
But like Beastmaster and Lone Druid are gonna be very tricky to gank. I mean,
Reserve
they will
time.
play very safe. They have both have a lot of HP, a lot of starting armor, at least on the Beastmaster. And Crystal Maiden, she is of course very easily killed, but she will play, well, Crystal Maiden being Crystal Maiden, she will stick to a tower and to the tower that where she is supporting her carry that's going to be picked
Mirana.
up. It's going to be Mirana. Even though of course Night Stalker may just die of towers, you know. It's a Night Stalker. And in that case, Crystal Maiden is not safe anywhere. let me just switch overlay so you can actually see more than just the things that you saw before. There we go. As we wait for everyone to pick up their hero, so I can go ahead and introduce you who's playing what. So we have M. Oh, we have all kind of letters. We have M playing the Enigma. We have G on the Queen of Pain. Art style on the Shadow Demon. 333 on the Lashrak. F on the Night Stalker. And oh, that's everybody from there. Okay. And I have a newly applied rule. If people don't want to be called by the name that they are, they should. Or if people want to be called by the name that they are, they should name themselves like that. So I'm gonna name them as they want to be named, which is like. Okay, I know that this is Stellaner, so I'm gonna say that once, and for the rest, I'm gonna call him Crystal Maine because this is unpronounceable. We have Nexus. He wants to be called Nexus, so I'm gonna call him Nexus. All the Mirana. We have Beastmaster being played by. I have to say, I'm not 100% sure who that is, but it's Starface, I guess. Cedro is playing the Lone Druid, and we have Poli Capuli. He is known as that previous games that I casted for him as well, and that's gotta be the Enchantress. I can check for you which one Beastmaster is if you want, and I think you want that. Let me check for a second. Maybe he's a stand-in. He's Tamar Wild. Okay, so Tamar Wild is on the Beastmaster. But then again, he should be called Tamar Wild if he wants to be called Tamar Wild. Hope everybody agrees with me on that. Maybe I'm just nitpicking.
Prepare
Don't want to
for
be doing that,
battle.
but oh well. There you have it. There you have it. And doesn't look like anything exciting is gonna happen. We will see everybody of zNation moving towards this bottom lane, but doesn't look like there is gonna answer that. And they're just Well, they're gonna spread out on their lanes, so I can see what kind of lanes they're going for. Like I said earlier, they have quite some options. From what it looks like now, M is gonna be solo laning the bottom lane on his Enigma, as we have a trial lane going towards the top lane with the Night Stalker there to take the farm Queen of Pain solo mid. So that is probably what's gonna happen. Night Stalker on a trial lane is gonna be Well, getting a lot of farm that way, and we might, well, you'll probably see the first blood on the top lane there too, and hopefully for Nightstalker he's gonna be able to be the one that takes the last hit for that.
30
But yeah,
seconds to
zNation just
battle.
scouting the forest, trying to see if they can find something. Maybe they will find the first rune. I have a ward placed down already. Crystal Maine being very behind. If Dera was in the forest right now, they could so easily pick off Crystal Maiden and, you know, get a first blood on her. But then again, there's nobody in the forest, so she is safe. Moving towards the bottom lane there. And gonna place another ward just to make sure that the creeps don't spawn. And there's not
The
gonna be
battle
any double
begins.
stacks. I don't think M would want to do that anyway. He's gonna be able to keep the lane pushed back regardless with his with demonic conversion. As we have Lone Druid moving towards the bottom lane, he's gonna be up first as an Enigma. In the middle, we will have the Beastmaster, so able to get that rune control and keep that rune control
Invisibility.
with his Call of the Wild, which you probably spec at level 2, I think. And we have, let's see, we have Enchantress going into the enemy forest with Crystal Maiden there too, who picked up the first rune as an invisibility rune. So we might see a quick first blood being attempted here on Enigma. If it's gonna succeed, that's of course another question. But Enchantress will have an Urza Warrior with her, so that will help a lot. As we see, oh, look at this. They're gonna try to find out if they can find Enchantress. They would have been able to kill Enchantress too. I mean, they have a disruption, they have a stun. They would be able to do that fairly easy, but they're gonna go towards the mid. Enchantress is not in the forest, so they're gonna try to get a kill on this Beastmaster, who has already been harassed quite a bit. Crystal Maiden making sure of that. Already had to pop herself, though. And it looks like Beastmaster, well, went the right way to eat a tree. He's not gonna be in range of anything. Is he really gonna try to dive a tower? No, is he? I'm not sure. In the meantime, well, Crystal Maine is still on the bottom lane, has let her invisibility rune run out. She doesn't want to. Oh, hello. Bye, Eidolons. And they actually get the last hits for all Eidolons, so the scouting Eidolons from Enigma found them, but also got them killed. But yeah, the invisibility rune no longer on Crystal Maine, so she didn't want to risk dying for that. As we still have. They're just sitting here waiting until the Beastmaster makes a move that they can go in on. Maybe Crystal Maiden is gonna push here a bit more, but no, G is just happily last hitting, not doing anything.
Radiant's
oh,
bottom
hello.
Tower is under attack.
Hello. Oh, they want the donkey. Do they? Ah, oh, but they stay over scene. Donkey's gonna be taking the safe route here. Scenic route home.
Radiant's bottom tower
They're diving on the bottom lane. Enigma is no longer there, though. He went into the forest. But the tower is gonna get pushed. And we'll drop here. As Lone Druid takes the last hit. So that's a very fast first tower. With Enchantress coming out of the forest with one of her creeps. Which is gonna run out. And M making sure that he still gets farmed by farming the jungle. Enchantress and Crystal Maiden looking for him. But okay. In the meantime, top lane, haven't been here yet. Because Mirana has been fairly safe with her leap. As the two Dare Roamers come back to the top lane, actually getting some experience now. They have not been getting any so far. And we see Arcel looking for that disruption, but the leap from Mirana was in time previous time. So she knows that they're there, and she's going to play it very safe, because disruption has a very long range, and she just doesn't want to get cut out. She rather misses experience and gold for that than having the chance to be caught out, because one disruption is practically a guaranteed kill. As the bottom tower gets pushed, and it doesn't look like anybody is here to defend it. But we do see Enigma going towards the middle lane, and Queen of Pain probably trying to defend this, but tower taking a lot of damage, and this tower will mean, if it goes down, that's such a huge advantage early game, having two towers down for your team. And yeah, tower goes down, Crystal Queen of Pain coming here. Not able to do an awful lot. He's gonna take the farm there instead. It's M's now on the mid lane, and he's gonna take some farm, or deny some farm for the Beastmaster and take some farm for himself, as he does have a soul ring. And looks like he's gonna be in the jungle right now too. In the meantime, this team is still level 1. There's two heroes of there, still level 1, and zNation already taking out two towers. So, very aggressive play from zNation from taking out towers, but these two want to play it aggressively, but they just don't get the chance to. The zNation has been so careful. As we see, Beastmaster picking up a double damage rune, is still level 5, is gonna find a regeneration rune. Crystal Maiden rotating to the top lane. And everybody, well, still save him. Still level 1 Shadow Demon and still level 1 Lashrak. Moving now to the middle lane and gonna get some experience here. They desperately need some experience. As M is gonna try to defend this tower against the pushing from the Crystal Maiden and Beastmaster Crystal, and Enchantress. Let's see if something's gonna happen here, because Arcel still wants to just drop his disruption. The thing now though, if they do get a kill, they'll get a kill of a hero a lot of levels higher than they are. And that will bring their experience back up a notch. As the Nightstalker's level 5, by the way, just checking the last hits for a bit while we see Mirana leaping away from this. Last hit 32 for 9 from the Nightstalker, as Mirana has 8 for 0, so it's really, really playing it very safe. But because of that, Nightstalker is getting a lot of farm. We'll probably see the gold graph, well, heavily in favor of the Dire, of course, because of the towers. But it's two towers, and you would expect more gold than that if you have two towers advantage for this early game. But that's just because, Nightstalker has been able to farm pretty freely. We have Lashrak level 2 now, finally, for him. And Queen of Pain getting a solid farm too. 32 last hits for her, 32 for 7. As we have Beastmaster, 21 for 2. So they have been versus each other for a while. So Queen of Pain having the advantage there. And we still have Mirana trying to take some farm. Crystal Maiden now coming in level 3 though. As we have some TPs coming out. They want to go for that Crystal Maiden. They want to go for that. Disruption is going to be there. Queen of Pain ulti going through. Enchantress is there too, as Shadow Strike is not hit on the Mirana, but Enchantress is gonna drop here. Last hit goes to Queen of Pain, and that's the first blood going towards there. A kill that they desperately needed. Oh, we have a shout going off on Arcel. Black Hole is casted to save him though, but are they gonna have enough damage to bring him down? He's level 6. Axes will fly through a miss. Right clicks are there, and Queen of Pain making sure that Beastmaster goes down before Arcel does. Enigma taking the last hit of that. But Queen of Pain shout, making sure that happened. And that's two kills for Dare on this. Everybody of Dare came here. Look, five heroes of Dare all towards the top lane. And well, Ciri was just happily farming here. Crystal Maiden was there first, but she didn't know how fast she could get out of there. She didn't even get picked off for Crystal Maiden. That's a very good job done. And Dara is gonna take some towers in return right now and to get back. There we go. Thank you, thank you, thank
Radiant's
you.
middle tower is
I
under
hope I didn't
attack.
miss anything. Oh, hey, this is weird.
Radiant
I hope it
structures are
updates soon, but
fortified.
it sounds like there's no kills then. Let's see if I missed any kills. No, it's still 2 for 0, even though the top lane, top numbers didn't update. Oh, we have a go on Enchantress. Shout going off on Nightstalker to help
Radiant's middle
save the
tower is
Enchantress.
under attack.
Heals will make sure that she dies. Oh, well, there's a disruption. Soulcatcher is there. And there is he is getting around so much. Void makes sure that he gets the kill. And there it is, 3 for 0 again on the top. So everybody knows again what's going on. As we see Beastmaster running for his life, there will be a Malefice Enigma Edict going down. Axis will fly through, but he will go down. Gonna try to do as much damage as he can before he dies. But Lashrak taking the last hit with his Edict there. And 4 for 0 now for Dara, as they have been roaming around to get those kills. Almost everybody was on that bottom lane. Everybody was on the mid lane, rather. Crystal Maiden is gonna drop here too. Last it goes to Queen of Pain. And that's 5 for 0. Quick kills here for Dara in his first nighttime. And not only for the Nightstalker. I mean, they still have a have some creeps pushing it on their tier 3 tower. But, you know, who cares? They're getting their gold from the kills right now. And they will get the gold from towers as soon as they got enough advantage on their heroes to take the towers down. They have a Lashrak. They shouldn't need to worry about towers. Lashrak will make sure that those towers go down. See, Spectre's Diabolic Edict, level 2. Ooh. I didn't lose power, by the way. I guess my connection dropped for a second. And then went back up. It knows that, so it just dropped. That's the reason. As we have, well, Dara and Arcel, or sorry, G and Arcel. These names. Are on the way, probably trying to get a kill, or Queen of Pain gonna farm some, and Shadow Demon's gonna try to get a good disruption so that Queen of Pain can blink in and start hitting her target. But there's 4 of zNation now in the forest of the Dire, all farming or standing still or doing other stuff. So they will be in a tricky position. Queen of Pain can of course blink away, but if Shadow Demon gets caught out, he doesn't have that easy a getaway. He can disrupt himself, but it will only buy him some time. And it won't be enough, and yeah, we're gonna see if he gets caught out though. Probably won't so far. So we have a Void going down on the Beastmaster. Malefice is there too. Lashrak misses his stun, but it doesn't matter because Beastmaster is gonna go down. Shout going off though on the Nightstalker. He's gonna try to run away. Axis will fly through. Might get a kill, though. Doesn't get a kill, but still goes down. Nightstalker getting the last hit with his Void. And Lashrak is safe. As the meantime, Enchantress does catch out the Shadow Demon in the forest. So that happened on the same time. And like I said, Shadow Demon does not have an escape, so that's exactly what happened. He may have disrupted himself or disrupted his opponent and tried to run away, but there were so many heroes of zNation in the forest that he couldn't do anything against that. We have a tower being, well, probably being brought down as the edict goes through. The islands are there to take care of some extra damage. We have some TPs coming in, but I don't think that they can do a lot for this. No, there we go. Nightstalker taking the last hit. Let's see what Nightstalker is building against. It's building up. He's 2400 gold, and he's gonna buy a Vitality Booster, so might go for a Vanguard, but I am, well, that would be, I'm not expecting a Vanguard. Maybe even a Heart ready. We will see. We will see. Of course, the thing, if you're gonna fight versus the Beastmaster, you have to make sure that if you're gonna be the target that gets brought down, and so far Nightstalker has been the target, you're gonna have to make sure that... Oh, hello Beastmaster. Malefice going off, Silence going off too. There should be a Void soon too. Is it needed though? Yeah, there's the Void. Gonna try to take the last hit with the Void, but the creeps actually took that. But yeah, I was saying, if you're gonna be versus the Beastmaster, you're gonna be in a team fight, and you're afraid that you'll get the shout and you'll get nuked down, what do? You get more HP to make sure that you survive the time that you're shouted at and can try to...
Dire's middle tower is
well, do damage still after you... after the shout runs out. And they're gonna take a tower for this skewer. Lashrak picking up the last hit for that one. Has got 1500 gold, buys up his mana boots. And we have a slow going off on the Crystal Maiden, but she will be able to get away. Too far. Darkness being popped by Nightstalker. Just cause he can. And so far, zNation, they know it's night. They know they have to play it so careful. And they're basically forced into their base. They can't really do that much. I mean, we saw Beastmaster overextending. He was still on his side of the river, but getting caught out and dying very fast. Sido, he has a nice amount of farm, though. Where is his bear? Where is his bear? Oh, there it is. Bear has picked up a relic. I mean, he did get free farm on that bottom lane there. So let's just pop out this screen for a second. We see Enigma on 70 last hits, but Lone Druid winning the last hit battle and has 79. Is going to be on 80 soon. 80 there. There we go. 80 last hits for Lone Druid as his bear takes care of the rest and gets him some extra last hit. We have a smoke coming off from zNation, and they're going to find the Shadow Demon in the jungle, or if they're going to go for the right way. They have a shout up. They have a shout up. Oh, they're gonna do the shout on the Nightstalker, and there goes Nova. But the shout is off. Frostbite is going off. Void is being done on Crystal Maiden, but it doesn't save him anymore. As Enchantress gets the last hit, Crystal Maiden might still die though. Gets a stun from the Shrek. The Shrek on the way out gets slowed. Queen of Pain taking care of the Crystal Maiden in the meantime, as we see Disruption going down to try and save it out of the Shrek. But will it be enough? No. Lone Druid taking the last hit on that one. A double kill for Queen of Pain as she takes down Enchantress as well, and we have Beastmaster, who is gonna be Malefice, stopping him from TPing out, and nothing he can save him. Triple kill for G on his Queen of Pain.
Top tower is under attack.
And that was a gank from zNation, starting out on the most tanky target at the moment for there. That's not a smart thing to do. Oh, Queen of Pain, where did you getting a kill on Mirana still? Using a Necronomicon to help out. Wow! Ultra kill all over the map as she teleported to the top lane. Got a kill here, still had mana to throw down some spells and made sure that she killed off four heroes so fast. Nice play by G, definitely, and sorry for missing that one. I was not expecting people to die so fast after that. Nightstalker indeed picking up a Vanguard. We have a Malefice and a Soulcatcher going off on the bear. Bear needs to die. Bear has a relic. They don't want a relic bear. Nope, they won't kill him though. Bear will be safe. But barely. That one was intentional. Sorry. And bear gets popped up new. So that he is full on HP once again. Sorry. Wow, lame humor I have. I know. Enigma having a mechanism up. And well, that will be very useful. I mean, they have a zNation doesn't have that much team fight, but if there will be a team fight, they will probably not drop that fast. Especially not if zNation is gonna try to take down Nightstalker as a first target again. I mean, he finishes Vanguard, he's gonna be even more tanky. I mean, if you take a look at like the previous smoke gank that we saw that caused zNation 4 lives, well, 4 in total and over the entire map. Hello. Oh no, nothing. They had a smoke up. They could have caught out the Lashrak, who was fairly close to. They could have caught out the Shadow Demon, who was close. But no! They went for the Nightstalker. And of course, Nightstalker needs to die. You know, in theory, he needs to be brought down to stop his farm. But if you're gonna aim for getting kills, at this moment, they can just do with any kills. They need the gold from the kills. As they already got gold from three towers and are still 4k behind on there. Dare, who has also taken down three towers, by the way. So, okay, that doesn't really make sense. Or at least, well, they're even on towers, but not even on kills, not even on farm. And they need some kills to make that farm be even again. And the Nightstalker can come later. Nova being brought down, but there's the Malefice. And there's a shout going off on the Nightstalker. Get disrupted, though. We'll be able to be saved right afterwards. And it's gonna back off afterward. Mirana leaping out as she was in a lot of trouble. Got the Soulcatcher on him. Mirana ultimate being popped. We have Lashrak taking a lot of damage. We'll go down here and do the bear. Enchantress taking the last hit as the rest of there is backing off. They don't want to fight that. They had, well, they didn't have the Queen of Pain there to take down, to take another ultra kill. And they lost Lashrak being left behind by his team to die. As the Crystal Maiden served as knight bait there. But yeah, they are gonna lose the tower for that, as she just managed to take down the tower. And it's gonna continue to pushing a little bit more while zNation is gonna take a Roshan. And I would expect there to know that this is happening. Or at least to send an island that way, and now they definitely know. Yeah, now they definitely know. You won't see it though, but it'll be clear. If they want to chase this though, if they want to try to get it instead of them, I'm not sure. Well, that would be too late anyway. Lone Druid picking up the Aegis. Lone Druid has not died yet once. He is a very tanky hero, so he already was hard to kill. He'll be even harder to kill. Though you have to remember, if they kill off the bear first and he comes back and he has his items on the bear, he has now a Radiant, by the way. He will still not have his bear if they manage to kill him off between the cooldowns. So that's probably going to be their aim. As we have the tower taking some damage here. Looks like Nightstalker wants to get the last hit on it. He'll try. Enigma picking up a Blink Dagger from the side shop in the meantime. And there we have Nightstalker taking the tower. And Enigma will be able to blink in and do a black hole. We have not seen... well, we have seen a black hole, actually. But not a black hole with more than one person in it. So I would be happy to see that. Nice play by Emir. Gonna stand here and is gonna be ready to just blink in and start doing his black hole. He is really ready for it. He wants it. You can tell. I'm gonna sit here and see him jump in and start casting it. Am I? You can do it, Em. You can do it. No? No? Fleshrack taking down the tower. And there's the blinking. And there's the black hole. But he only catches Enchantress. Shout going off too. So the black hole gets cancelled. Em is taking a lot of damage. Going down to the Maran. In the meantime, Son from Fleshrack gets two. Queen of Pain. Shout going through. Doing a lot of damage. But Maran gets a triple kill. She kills off the Queen of Pain and the Fleshrack. And the Enigma getting the kill for that too, getting an ultra kill for that one, killing off the Shadow Demon as Nightstalker is the only one left alive. Aegis is popped on the Lone Druid, but I am expecting, there we go, Nightstalker going down to Enchantress taking that last hit, and that's a great fight for zNation. As I do believe Em was a bit premature on the black hole, but he just really wanted it. You could see him wanting it. So they got a tower, but lost five of their heroes and gave Mirana an ultra kill. That is definitely... important kills to get for Mirana. I mean, she was behind on farm. You saw her at the start of the game versus the Nightstalker. She was not happy farm-wise, but this will get her almost back in the game. This will ramp her farm up by quite a bit. So we're just going to see the gold per minute for a second. So we have Queen of Pain of 484, and that's going to be actually almost as high as Lone Druid, who is on 490. So he has been getting free farms, and his bear is now also farming with the Radiance, of course. So those two are the highest farmed heroes on the map. But Mirana now on 330, so almost catching up on the Nightstalker, who's on 390. And that's that ultra kill, making sure that happened. And I would expect there to play a bit more careful now, as they know that they can't underestimate zNation and can't really push or try to take team fights the way they did. I mean, they could have taken the tower and then backed off, but they chose to go for it anyway. Oh, do I? There. Thank you for that. And well, they're gonna try to push in anyway. Okay. So they're not gonna play more careful. No, they're gonna go for it. They don't have a black hole right now, but all of their are here. There's a smoke up from Mishrak here. And the Shadow Demon, they might try... Oh, hello. Hello, Beastmaster. You are the target. He has a shout, so he can do that much, but... Oh, he's gonna try to hide himself. Blink is there. Disruption is there, too. Malefice will shortly follow up. Son from the Shrek will punish up, too. There's a Malefice. The Shrek, Edith going through. The Shrek, Nova going through and actually taking the last hit with that, too. And in the meantime, the top lane is being pushed by G on a Queen of Pain, making sure that Enchantress is just having to stand here because she can't risk... having G push in, so she has to defend it in case they're gonna be there. Crystal Maiden being there too. But G TPing back, just wasting some of Enchantress's her time. Who's gonna be able to take the farm on the top lane, but still. As the rest of there is now moving towards the top lane. So making zNation believe that they have backed off. Oh, Crystal Maiden, Void is there, but there's the Lone Druid, Frostbite is there, Nightstalker taking a hit, taking an arrow, getting disrupted to try and save his life, might actually do so, as he's gonna try to run away, but will be enough, and Enchantress doing a large hit there with the Epithis and drops his gem as well. So Enchantress taking a big kill there, as Nightstalker just fell for the bait of Crystal Maiden overstepping out of her base. If it was intentional or not, it succeeded by zNation. Queen of Pain with double damage rune in her bottle right now. Let's see if zNation can take the advantage back that Dare had, or at least make this line go to zero. They do a very good job with having this, well, this line here. It's a team fight that they lost. And this line up is again the farm that Dare was able to do while they were forced out in their base, or forced down in their base. Out in their base? I don't know. Because Queen of Pain was coming to push in. But we will see, there we go, dropped down again. That's a nice target getting killed, and them getting killed farm on the top lane once again. And everybody there, of course, being pushed back. Let's see, we have Queen of Pain, who has her Necronomicon. We already saw that one earlier. She is now building towards the Aghanim Scepter, so she will be able to pop her Sonic Wave every 40 seconds. Which will be, well, a great thing to have. Just pumping out that extra nuke damage. And we have Enigma, who has a Blink Dagger. We already saw the mech, we already saw the Soul Ring. Let's see what Enchantress is building. Building towards the Mechanism also, but is not going all that fast. Has the Urn of... Never called it Urn of Shadows. It's the first time I see that it's called Urn of Shadows, I think. And we have a smoke going off. She has actually 6 charges in her urn, and for having 10 kills, she has not used a lot, I have to say. Well, maybe not in the possibility to use it. Beastmaster having his gem up right now. And with his gem, I mean the gem that he stole from the Night Stalker. Has a Hood 2 probably building towards a pipe just to be able to withstand the damage I was just talking about from Queen of Pain. Because that will be very useful. As Lone Druid is probably building towards Assault Karas to put on his bear. Where is his bear anyway? I don't know. I'm not going to follow the bear as we see Artstyle being forced back by a boar. Always nice. Mirana building towards their Mantis style, almost has it completed. Just needs a couple hundred more gold to get the recipe. And it looks like Dara wants to push in. Do they have a new gem? No, they don't. Nope. Nova going down, stopping the creep wave from pushing in. Crystal main. Everybody of zNation being forced back into the base again right now. And maybe this is what they're once as they're backing off a bit, maybe waiting for the creep wave. That would be probably more logical. But no, they're gonna go back to farming. They don't want to have a 5-on-5 team fight there. They rather probably take some kills and well, then push in 4 versus 5. Or what they did now was they're already back to farming right now, while everybody else of zNation is still holding back. So this will actually give Dare more time to farm than zNation has right now, even though, of course, they're going to be able to farm closer to their base, but they're getting a farm advantage as it is. Shadow Demon having his Medallion of Courage up, as well as Power Thread, says just, he's a support. He's been warding also, and just as Medallion of Courage, making sure that the target that get nuked are able to get nuked way easier. And we have a Roshan almost back again, couple minutes, 2 minutes time. I think, if I can read this properly. Which I probably can, but doesn't matter. And with also a Soul Catcher there, that target that has a Soul Catcher and a Medallion of Courage on him, that will die so fast with all the nukes that are coming out from there. And that's so much better that they now have, or that they're building towards a pipe at least. Even though they might not have one yet. And Queen of Pain only 200 gold away from her Aghanim. And Lashrek, having a soul booster and a point booster. If he splits his boots up, he has a soul booster. But he's probably going to wait until he can actually complete the whole Bloodstone. And then he will have a Bloodstone to be able to just run around with tons of HP, tons of mana, and just having his Nova just going up and, you know, doing damage to stuff while he can just run around pretty much, well, without fear of getting killed off too fast, at least, before being useful. Oh, it's getting closer. We see that. Oh, are the red lights pulsing thingies? Are those new? It's pulsing. I think it is new. It's probably new. Crystal Main has a smoke up, just in case they're ready to go for it. They might actually go for it right now, as everybody's grouping up into this patch here. But will they? They might. And it's really now waiting. It's a waiting game. I have to say, Black Hole can make the teamfight go severely into the direction of Dare, but they have to get out of a good one, because the previous one wasn't really that impressive with only one. Nikma did pick up a Ghost Scepter also, so we'll be able to withstand the attacks from Rana a lot better if he gets caught out. But yeah, it's a semi-waiting game. They have to Dara has to pick someone off before they're gonna go in, before they want a team fight, because they just don't want to risk it. It would be best, of course, if that would be the lone druid. And both teams already know that Roshan is up, so they're gonna be a fight here. Nova going down, arrow's gonna fly, doesn't hit anything though. Disruption going off on himself, make sure that he's safe. Gonna try to take off the bear, but actually the bear doing a lot of damage with his radiance on the illusions right now, but is taking a lot of damage too. As we're gonna see Mirana trying to get picked off, leaps away though, is gonna be chased down. He's gonna take a demonic purge. As we see art style probably dropping one more right click, nice stalker taking the kill. Mirana in the meantime, disruption was in time to save off or save art style. In the meantime, we have a Malphite on the Queen of Pain, or at least no, not a Malphite, because of course it's on our same team. Crystal Maiden dropping, nice stalker getting a double kill with that hit. In the meantime, Zero managed to kill off the Enigma, and that's 2 for 2. Crystal Maiden buys back. We have Shadow Demon buying back too. And well, both teams don't want to give away Roshan, but both teams don't want to try this yet either. Oh, Enigma disconnected. Yeah. There, we're gonna probably have a pause. As I don't think they're noticed it. There we go. There we go. They noticed that their teammate's missing. Only now. It's very friendly though that did he die before the fight? This is so annoying that you can't see that. But Enigma got killed off before. He disconnected before he died. So that is quite painful for Dare. Double damage rune on Queen of Pain. Almost ran out. By the way, the thing that I called Malphite on Queen of Pain was actually a Frostbite, of course. Just saying. She now has her Aghanim's Scepter complete. So she will be able to do her Sonic Wave, which she didn't do in the previous fight. If you can really call that a fight, it was just two teams trying to be very careful, but a couple of heroes overextending and one actually disconnecting. A lot of things going off. BKB up on the Night Stalker. Has 1k gold. Also won't be able to buy back though. He'll lose too much gold when he dies. If he dies. But we'll withstand the stuns from... Or at least we'll withstand the Frostbite and the... Nope, not the Impetus. Pure damage. Not the Shout. It's gonna go through BKB. So only the Mirana stuff that's gonna happen. But Mirana's dead. So doesn't matter. Not gonna do that much. As we have Lashrak still backing up, only a little bit of HP left, as he still has not got enough gold to finish off his Bloodstone. Almost though, almost. It won't be able to buy back either. Well, actually, it will be very close. A lot of unreliable gold though. Probably won't be enough to buy back. It might be. It will be tricky. It will be on the edge. Like, yeah. Either you can or you can't. Goes for every hero, of course. I know. But you know, smart. Beastmaster, having finished this Pipe of Insight, which he has used in a previous fight, and we're waiting once. One sack from zNation. This is tactical pause now. It turned into a tactical pause. They're gonna decide how to do this, how to get the Roshan. Even though I do think Roshan is an important thing to have, I mean, it will give you the safety of pushing in, knowing that one of your heroes will be back alive, and so you can basically sacrifice one of your heroes, if you want to call it that, which you probably don't. But if it's worth losing a teamfight over for both teams, I mean, if Dare loses a teamfight here, they will lose Roshan, and maybe a tier 2 tower. Maybe a tier 1 tower on the top lane, because that one's still standing. If zNation loses a teamfight here, I have to add, if zNation wins the teamfight, they're going to be able to go back to the top lane, as the creep wave is there. And the creep wave is on the bottom lane too, so they might take some towers on a tier 3, damage on a tier 3 tower. Oh, Queen of Pain, hello, what are you doing there? Gonna get a kill, the Crystal Maiden is gonna go down here, the Lone Druid getting that kill, but not before Crystal Maiden died because of her Sonic Wave, as Cedo is barely alive, gets an urn charge, and Nightstalker doesn't want to go in anymore. It was a bit over-aggressive from G, even though it probably does make them think twice about going into the Roshan pit right now. Yeah, if Dare wins a teamfight here, they can either go for Roshan, which they probably will then, but they could also try to go for tier 3 tower in the mid, as the tower is getting pushed by their creeps right now, even though they get pushed back now, so that, you know, zNation is doing that. Tier 1 tower on the top lane fell, by the way, by the creeps, so last tier 1 tower out of the game right now. As the Shrek is there to push down the creep wave. Let's see. Here he is. He's using his mana to do so, and we'll have enough soon for his... Bloodstone. I'm just thinking, it doesn't look like Dara really wants to compete them for it. It would be 3 versus 4, 3 versus 5. We gotta make some copies, sending some into the pool. He has level 4 disruption. Oh, they back up instantly! Look at that! The leap from Nexus was as fast as you can expect an arrow going through. Oh, he's actually gonna hit! Arrow hits on a Night Stalker, but it's too far away to go for it, but Lone Druid is still picking up the Aegis. It was a 5-second stun, a couple of seconds stun at least on the Night Stalker there. Invisibility. As they're gonna counter towards stun, they still have the gem of the lone, Beastmaster. But yeah, easy Roshan then for zNation. Nobody winning or losing a teamfight, so my theories didn't really get put to the test, which is a shame. So I can just say that they're right. So you know, nobody will be able to check it anyway. We have an invisibility rune on Leshrac, and he has now got his Bloodstone completed by the farm that he got on that top lane. As a Lone Druid is probably building towards his BKB, got an Ogre Club. And let's see if the bear got anything else. Yeah, Salt Grass is completed also, which we saw being built earlier. And he just put it on his bear to make him extra tanky. And he's gonna kill off some Ancients to get more farm that he already has, which I'm just gonna point out, almost 500 gold per minute for him. And nobody comes close to that right now. Queen of Pain dropped to 450 gold per minute. Still quite okay, still quite high, but... you know, it's no Lone Druid. Though she did get more kills. She has 8 for 2, Lone Druid 3 for 0. Okay, so the kills is 5 difference, but at least Lone Druid did not die yet, as the only hero in the game that has not died yet. And if you consider that, it's quite... well, we did see the Aegis being popped in a previous fight where he had the Aegis. But... considering he hasn't died yet, he might not be the smartest target to have an Aegis on. Since you would rather put that on someone... that, like a Mirana, she gets killed off quite a bit, and she is able to pump out so much damage with her Mantis Cell that's now complete. So I would prefer to see Mirana with the Aegis, but then again, we might see the Aegis being popped then again in the next fight before Mirana goes down, and in that case, zNation will say, "Told you so," and of course that's why they are playing, and I'm sitting here. And let's see what Dare is gonna be doing now. If they're gonna actually try to push in at some point, which, well, like I said, they have the advantage in a team fight, but they really have to get it proper. They have to get a good black hole coming out from the Shrek. So far, that has not happened yet. And he has to get the Beastmaster too. That's the most important thing. He has to get the Beastmaster in the black hole, because otherwise the black hole will just get interrupted by the shout. Or, of course, he can wait until the shout is done and then go in with the black hole. And then it's okay if he doesn't have the Beastmaster with that yet. Let's see who's winning this farm battle now after... wow, look at that. I mean, I want to say after the fight at Roshan Pit, which is probably this. Like, going towards zNation, as we knew. But this is just so even for a 33-minute game. That is quite impressive from both teams, I have to say. Being able to, to form their own tactic, to stick with their own tactic, and just keeping it so even. Even though, of course, both teams don't want that, so I say impressive from both teams, even though it's, of course, not really what they were aiming for. They were aiming to be ahead, but still. We see BKB almost completed on the Lone Druid, just need 300 more gold, well actually 200 to complete his BKB, just a recipe. And with that recipe, when he has that up, they actually, since they have the Aegis, they're probably going to see them push in before this timer runs out, so that they can at least use the Aegis. Oh, this timer. See, I have to draw circles on the map. It's cool, I heard that today. And everybody else here farming 2800 gold on the Night Stalker. Wonder what he's gonna go for, actually. He has got quite some options. Might be going for extra tankiness or extra survivability, but he already has a Vanguard, so is quite tanky. And when he gets focused down, He'll probably die anyway. As in, if there is and a shout and a frostbite, and that would mean that the rest of his team is nowhere close, then he will die. Oh, my Queen of Pain is in trouble. She does always have a blink. Is probably going for that sheep stick just to be able to get rid of that big walking bear that's there. But when he has a BKB, which he does now, she will have to wait until that one's over. Oh, Mirana. Mirana doesn't have a BKB. He's probably going for an MKB here to stab that piercing armor.
Radiant's top tower
Not
is under
piercing.
attack.
Yeah, she will pierce armor with her shot as the tier 2 tower is going to get in. And they're going to go push in. They have the Aegis, they have the BKBs that they wanted. They have the pipe, they have the mech. They have the bear doing tons of damage on this tower. Fortification going off. TPs are being forced out, and there's going to be a stun going off on the Night Stalker here. Disruption coming off on the Shadow Demon himself as the bear is just continuously hitting on that tower, and it's probably gonna get summoned back as soon as he was almost about to die. There we go. Bear is back to full HP, being summoned back, and the tower is only 70 HP, so a couple more hits from that bear. They could just, if they wanted to, which apparently they don't, and they're gonna push out into their TP back to their base to stop pushing from coming. But if they wanted to, they could go in again and send the bear just to do 2 hits, and the tower will be down. This is a very tricky situation for Dare to be in. Actually, probably Lone Druid could semi-backdoor that, at least go in there and start letting his bear hit and then take the tower and go back. His bear is doing so much damage right now, and extra damage to buildings also. There we go, demolish. Bonus building damage, 40%. It's just very painful to deal with. Yeah. Queen of Pain building towards her sheep stick, so she's gonna sheep the Mirana when she can, because she is getting a dangerous force here, just secretively farming the whole game long, and well, getting that ultra kill, of course, that kind of made people think, oh yeah, there's a Mirana in this game too. But yeah, she's gonna be very dangerous and shooting from the sidelines, so she will be turned into a sheep and nuked down. She doesn't have that much HP. I mean, 1400, she will be able to get nuked down quite fast, as we have been seeing that. We have been seeing that happening in the previous team fights, even though there were semi team fights. But still. Enigma, still not able to put down that black wall that he really wanted to. We have 2400 gold still up on Enigma. He will be able to be buy back if needed there. And the thing is, right now, Dare has to have gold for buybacks. I mean, if they lose a team fight now, they'll probably lose a tier 3 tower and maybe even a barracks, depending on where the fight is happening, of course. And it looks like they want to push in this mid lane. They're going to be able to push it in too. We're gonna see Queen of Pain trying to do the same thing on top lane, but I would expect zNation to just continue pushing. They have the better push right now. They could go for this. They could. No. They don't want to. They rather defend. They rather defend. Playing it safe, very important in the game of Dota, of course. Making sure you don't overextend, you don't purposely give stuff away when you're not entirely sure if you can take something back. So they're not going to continue to push in. And then Nidor is there. They're going to stay behind in the jungle. And yeah, we have a 4 staff up on Enchantress to help more, support more. Making sure that if someone's close to the Night Stalker, he can just 4 staff people away. The Night Stalker is harmless again. And of course, can force them out of the stun. Force them out of a lot of stuff. Or into a lot of stuff also, of course. If you're standing on the higher ground defending your tower and you'll get 4 staff down, you might find yourself in a very tricky position. Take a quick look at the gold graph that is still so even. A bit in favor of there, but that's only the farm right now. Oh, hello. Mirana. Oh, she noticed. She leaps away instantly. Even though it looked like Dare was expecting the rest of her team to be there too, they of course did not know that the rest of her team was... 4 of them were farming the Ancients. But yeah, Mirana being there all by herself. So, yeah, but she will be safe, and as will the rest of there. And we see Lashrak pushing down his mid lane, stopping the pushing from happening, rather. It's not really pushing in anything right now. As G is still hanging out in this top lane, not getting that much farm in the meantime. Well, now he is, but wasn't earlier. And, oh, there we go. Everybody of zNation is on the top lane. If they can manage to pick off G, if they can do that, or anyone else, like Shadow Demon, for example, then they will have such well a lot easier time to push into the in the base, and they will probably then go for it. But they'll be able to get away. These two, our stones, you will be able to move back and be safe, even though it was close. Warhounds also got a very long range. 4k gold up on the Night Stalker, 4.3 gold actually, more precise. And we still have not had the Aegis pop. Being popped, rather. We still have that one. Look, Aegis on the Lone Druid. Aegis. And do they want to push in before this runs out? That's the question. Or do they just want to go for the next one as soon as this one runs out? They will have to go for the next one because it won't be enough time anymore for them to look. It's going down. It's happening. There we go. Roshan back. Aegis gone on the Lone Druid, and now Roshan will have a cheese. And Crystal Maiden already know that Roshan is back. I wonder if Dara knows though. They should, because they should have put the clock and stuff. But they will take Roshan. In the meantime, top lane is getting pushed as Arcel and G are back on the top lane and probably expecting to have indeed zNation getting the Roshan over, but they're not in time to take something in return. Or they might though. TPs are getting forced out. We have TPs from Crystal Maiden incoming. We have a TP from the Enchantress. Crystal Maiden throwing down a Nova, just forcing them back, warning them that they're there. And Enigma is gonna be there too. Night Stalker is gonna be there too, just in case.
I am ever
where's the arrow? Oh, arrow hits on G. Are they gonna go in though? Yes, they are. Mirana getting a Malefic though. Disruption is gonna be there to save the Queen of Pain. And Blink to Waste right after. Nice disruption as CDO wants to chase this, but it doesn't look like the arrow is gonna let them. Just checking something. No. So MKB completed on the Mirana. She's going full cannon. Still, well, has her power threads too to set to agility, so it's not got that much HP. But then again, it was 1500. It's not that bad, to be fair. It's still more than Enigma. All fears fading. That's not gonna be hard, of course. And Aegis up on not on the Lone Druid, because he has a cheese. He also has a relic again. Uh-oh. Is he going for what I'm thinking he's going for? He has still not died once. So we have a smoke up. Let's see what the Aegis is on. Mirana has the Aegis then, probably. Yes, she has. Well, for the exact reason that I said previous time, actually. Probably. So that would be that Mirana is actually the one that gets caught out, and this time when she dies, it will give a big impact because she has so much damage right now that, well, you want her to stay alive twice. You want her to be alive twice, and she has died as one of the earlier targets in the previous fight. So this time, if it does happen again, she'll be back up and be ready for another fight, as we have the gold graph still quite even. This is not any item difference, this is just the heroes that will make a difference, and of course initiation. Because will M be able to put down a good black hole? Look at them, they're pretty grouped up here. If he blinks in at the right time, gets a black... What the hell? Technical pause! Where's M? There he is. He wants to get a black hole again. This time he wants to get more. And it doesn't look like zNation is paying that much attention to their positioning. I mean, Beastmaster is standing pretty far back. Crystal Maiden is standing pretty far forward. You'd normally see it the other way around, but then Crystal Maiden is doing her awesome right leg's damage in this tower right here. But the bear is doing the same thing. Enchantress is being far back, and of course Lone Druid is going to pull his bear back as soon as the tower drops, or if the bear drops, whichever comes first. And I think M should be able to put down a good black hole. We saw them like a second ago. They were. Oh, I can count. No, you can't count. You can't see it on the map. Damn it! When it's paused. But yeah, this little area is where four heroes were just a short while ago. Were very clumped up, and if they're gonna do that again, which they might, because they have been moving around quite a bit, then there will be a good black hole possibility for M. If they're going to be able to do the damage in the meantime to make sure the heroes die, that's a different question. There is a sheep stick up for Queen of Pain, so she will be able to sheep them around, and they might be able to get her down at least once, as that she has the Aegis, so she will be back up. But they have a lot of magic damage right now. I mean, Night Stalker still has almost 5k gold, has not bought anything yet since I said at 2400 gold. I wonder what he's going for. But yeah, we still don't know. I maybe at this moment, maybe I'm thinking like something of a basher, but or maybe still on the sword cuirass, but he can go for, he has a lot of options right now. It really depends on how they want to play him. And well, the where is that guy? Oh, there he is. The Shadow Demon will only be able to put up Soulcatcher on one else. I have to say though, this build from Shadow Demon not going for anything of a Shadow Poison, it's quite unique. I normally see people going for Shadow Poison at least once, maybe just for the vision even. But he doesn't want that. He wants the extra stats. He has another agenda. Oh, we might see this going again. Okay, go is on. We can go. We can go. And they have, both teams have managed to talk about what's gonna go on. Bear is gonna take him out of it. Is Bear gonna drop? Bear is gonna drop, but get popped out immediately. But there's now a cooldown from 2 minutes. They might wanna go for this Bear again though, but they stopped the pushing from happening. Okay, that was not as exciting as I was hoping it to be. But that is also because of the pause. Oh, Bear. No, Bear was safe. But now Nightstalker is on the wrong side. He's gonna walk back though. Shout going off on the Shadow Demon. Shadow Demon being an easy target to take down. Cut and gets an arrow. It's gonna be taken down. And Mirana taking the last hit of that one. Able to do so much damage. And it's gonna look at the damage that Mirana's doing at the tower. Also, tower is down. And the pipe is up. They want to go in for this. Mirana hitting on the barracks with her illusions. And now for herself too. As we have a slow on the Queen of Pain, who still sends down her Sonic Wave, but the Bear, oh, there's the Black Hole, catching four of zNation's heroes, and there's the Max to Mirana going down, Aegis being popped, Nightstalker trying to get away, well, Enigma is gonna drop here, and the Bears go down too, but the Black Hole was perfect, and, well, not perfect enough, as Nightstalker goes down too, Rain's Barracks going down, this tower was already so low, as the buybacks come out, we have Enigma buyback, we have Nightstalker buyback, Tier 3 tower goes down and everybody of zNation is backing off. They're gonna be fine. As in the meantime, we have Lushrak, lone soldier, managed to take down the barracks on the top side. He's gonna give his life for that, but definitely worth it. He took down the barracks and the ranged barracks are the only one left, only thing left standing. I'm not sure. Well, it was definitely worth it for zNation, but giving Lushrak's life for that kill, that was worth it. Even though I think that if Lushrak would have been here on this middle lane during the black hole, that would have been so much extra damage being done. That would have won them the entire fight. It would probably still, the barracks would have still gone down. So in that that sense, it's probably not a bad decision to send him up there in the lane. But yeah, good defense from there, for as far you can call a good defense that they you know, lost barracks. And well, good choice by Dare to send down Lushrak towards the top lane, being able to take something in return. Even though they did lost a lot of heroes, they did have a lot of buybacks. We do have Nightstalker picking up a Hyperstone, so he's probably going for that, well, I'm thinking Assault Cuirass. Mjolnir, I'm not sure. I would have expected him to go for Maelstrom first if he was going to go for Mjolnir, so. Lone Druid actually picks up a Skullbasher. And does he really? Where's the Bear? Oh, there he is. No, okay. I was thinking, does the Bear have a Radiance too? But no, there is a Relic and Radiance. He switches every item to himself and will probably give the Basher to the Bear, maybe. Maybe he will give the Basher to the Bear. I'm not sure. We're gonna see that the Donkey will bring it to him. Oh! What am I talking about? Basher Abyssal Blade. There we go. He just made sure he had that and has everything on himself. So next time when the Bear will get focused down, because that's what he does. Well, that's he's gonna get focused down, and look at the drawing on the main map. They're gonna push in the middle lane and gonna go then for the barracks on the top side. But yeah, they don't need the druid, sorry, the bear anymore to hit on those tier 3 towers, as those two are down that they want to have, and they only need them to kill the melee barracks, and they can do that by themselves if they have the time, because they're not that tanky. TPs are gonna come out, but if they're gonna be out in time, that's the question. Nightstalker's the only one here, gonna put a void down on the bear, sun gonna go off on the bear, Malefic going off on the bear, there's no black hole though, Shout going off too, and Lushrak going down, and Chantra's taking a double kill, killing off both of them, as Mirana pops her BKB, which she got in the break, which is now between the team fights, is gonna go for the barracks instead of chasing down hero kills, and Crystal Main gets a kill on the Shadow Demon near the tower, but the barracks go down very fast, and this might just be a GG, as the tier 4 tower gets pushed up down very fast by Nexus on his Mirana. Tier 4 tower going down, arrow is not gonna hit, nice evasion. G taking a lot of damage, Malefic on Mirana still. X is going through. Black Hole being casted catches four of zNation's hero, but Mirana is going to hit him from the sidelines. Will do enough damage. No, it's not going to get her down. G buying back to the game. And there's the GG coming out from Artstyle as we see all tier 4 towers dropping. And zNation just taking down the throne. And we have instant disconnects also. As wow, this was a win for zNation. Managed to take the game with very much control over the game also. They've been managing to hold their lines pretty solid, apart from the first minute when they were 5-0, I believe. But then